My mother and father kept having children, it ended up being five of us. And so the life at the house was just a little kind of crazy. And I figured the best place to get the attention I was needing and seeking would be school. And so that started the whole ball of wax. And my experience at school was somewhat difficult, to say the least. I failed the third grade, which I'm not proud of. But it was that type of trying to understand what I was feeling inside. My parents was frustrated because here's this child that just wouldn't act right, just wouldn't, kind of go down the golden rule, stay in line. I was always popping outside of that line, trying to figure it all out, I guess. But I was a child that was just inquisitive, and I love the attention. So I would kind of do whatever it took to get that attention. And then as a result, it came at a cost again, failing third grade. And by the time I reached sixth grade, I was a mess. My grades finally got to the point where I could actually reach the sixth grade. But by that time, my parents were taking me from one psychologist to the next, trying to figure out what was going on. Fortunate enough, there was an experience that I tell when I go to schools. So you have to have me come to a school, and I will finish that story. But there's experience that experience led to my uncle realizing that I was drowning, and that I needed help. So the man that he was, I just lost my uncle last year. He decided that he was going to do something that was going to help me out, help his sister's son, his nephew. And so what he did. He left New Jersey. I was living at the time with my mother and father in Philadelphia. He left New Jersey, crossed the Tacony-Palmyra Bridge into New Jersey, and knocked on my front door and said, "Come with me." And he picked me up and he took me to Sagamore art class. And what was amazing about this, that he did this for 6 years straight. He had three other children. He had his own three daughters, but he would leave his three daughters home on a Saturday morning, and he would sacrifice his Saturday to be with me. Amazing. When I had stayed with grandmom and granddad, my uncle would come down to visit his parents. Right? I knew this. And he would come down and he would spend countless hours with me looking at the drawings that I produced. And he would go through each drawing and sit down and say, "Well," and ask the question, like, "This drawing that you did here, I love it, but explain to me, what was your patience?" I'm like, "Excuse me?" He's like, "Your patience." I said, "I don't understand the question." He says, "Well, example. The clouds that you painted here, are those the clouds you saw, or are those the clouds you just made up?" I said, No, I saw those clouds." He said, "That's what I mean, your patience." I said, "Ah." So I was having those kind of deep, rich conversations with my uncle. And so that was part of, I'm sure he had a plan there, and didn't let me in on it, but I'm sure when he did, it changed my life.